today we want to deliver two lectures.
One is a fraction order element. This is basically constant phase impedance for sensing application, such as humidity, water quality, and milk quality. And there will be another lecture that is on importance and adoption of smart sensor. So actually, this fractional order device, in fact, when I was doing PhD in 2003 to 2006, and at that time, there was a group in IIT Kharagpur, and she was Dr. Korobi Bishas. Now she is a professor there, and she was working on fractional order element. And that time, we were doing one workshop in IIT Kharagpur, and she was just published on research article on fractional order element for monitoring the quality of milk. So she used to bring that sensor in the workshop also, and we are basically now nearly 40 or 30 participants out there from different part of the country. In fact, still I remember, she brings one stick, and she was telling it is a constant phase element. It is a PCB basically. It is a PCB, maybe dimension is 2 centimeter by 4 centimeter. But she is telling that this is the PCB. I have used it for testing the quality of milk. So really it very interesting that time I was thinking. It's so simple device, but it is doing so wonderful job. So what was that? But then my research area was different. I was working on porous silicon based vapor sensor, and that is for humidity and as well as for electronic nose application. But I had interest on that simple device, because I always like simple thing, so that it does not create problem to make the device, but it is having wonderful application. But it was a fractional order, so again it is a new thing to me. So I am not able to understand what is fractional order, why it is called constant phase element. But today, only what I find, that fractional, fractants and fraction, it is very old, you can say, techniques are there, but there is no real-time device till today, which is based on fractional order device. This is the group in IIT Kharagpur, still they are working, and they are really doing very wonderful work on fractional order element for different application. They have used this concept for sensing application. They have used this concept for designing a filter. They have used this concept for designing ADC. They use the concept for design integrator, for differentiator. So many interesting application and interesting features they have obtained using the fractional order device. So let us see, we try to, according to my understanding, I am trying to tell you what is fractional order and how it can be useful to us. So first thing is that, outline is that, what do you mean by fractional order device? The methods for realization of fractional order device, application of fractional order device, and challenges ahead. These are the four things that I want to consider here. Now let us see, we are already familiar with resistance. Simply, it is basically ratio of voltage to current. We know every day. So suppose this is a resistance element, its value is R, and this is the voltage, excitation voltage, and this is forcing a current I. So we know that R is equal to V by I. That is basically according to the Ohm's law that we know. We can also write this expression in this way, that V is equal to R d 0 I by dt 0. It means I have written this expression in a differential form. Okay? So suppose this is a differential equation of order 0. And this is nothing but this is equal to Ri. It means the resistance, it is an element of order 0. Okay? Now let's come to the inductance. Here we know this is basically value is L, and if the voltage excitation is V and current is I, then we know in differential form the equation is VL di by dt. So if you compare this one, the difference is that here it is 0, here it is 1. So it means the inductor, it is an element with order 1, differential order 1. Then come to the capacitor. Again, it is a capacitor, value is C, voltage is V, and current is forcing current is I. We know that this voltage, it can be written in integrated form. It is just in a different way, 1 by C, 0 to T, I dt. And if you write in a differential form, it should be minus 1. It means the capacitor, it is basically having the order minus 1. This is a pure capacitor. The inductor, that is a pure inductor. It is a, you can say, ideal inductor. And resistance, that is also pure resistance. So for capacitor, it is basically having order minus 1. It means the three basic elements that you use for representing any system by electrical engineering, equivalent circuit, resistance, capacitor, and inductance, these three elements having zero order, one order, and minus one order. Now suppose, similar way, you take one device. Device I've represented by this symbol. We don't know what is there. But suppose it is V and I, and I'm writing this element in this way. V is equal to Q d alpha I by dt alpha, where alpha is greater than minus 1 and 1. It means the values of alpha lies within 1 to minus 1. If it is 1, then it become inductor. If it is minus 1, it become capacitor. If it is 0, then it become resistance, isn't it? So it means these three elements I can write in this expression. If alpha is 0, then simply it is Q into I. So Q, it means Q is basically your resistance. If I write alpha is 1, Q di by dt alpha, then it is basically Q di by dt. So in this case, this is your inductance. If I write minus 1, then Q d, this is basically your capacitor. So I can write this basically expression. If you take the Laplace transform, this is the differential form. If you take the Laplace transform, where Laplace operator is S, in that case, we represent Vs is equal to Q S to the power alpha I into S. Okay, so Vs by Is, this is basically Q S to the power alpha. And that we can call it is the impedance, isn't it? So what is impedance? It is basically ratio of Laplace form of voltage to Laplace form of the current, and that is giving a Q S to the power alpha. So voltage-current relationship in a fractional order, in a fractals, follows fractional differential equation with order alpha. So in a fractional device, it is just like you can say impedance, resistance, capacitance, inductance, but alpha value varies from minus 1 to 1. Even you can call the capacitor, it is a fractional element, but order is minus 1. Inductor, it is a fractional element, order is 1. Resistance, it is a fractional element, order is 0. Let us see the properties. So in order to see the property, see, so it means the impedance, it is Vs by Is. I'm writing Q by S to the power alpha. If you replace S by J omega is basically the, omega is the frequency, and then it is becoming Q by J omega. So I can write this is Q by omega to the power alpha, and in angle minus pi by 2 by alpha, isn't it? So it means the fractional impedance Zs, we can represent by, this is the polar form of the impedance. We have a polar form representation and rectangular form of the representation. So in this polar form, it is the magnitude and this is the phase angle. Now suppose if plot this one, minus pi by 2 by alpha, Q by omega. Now suppose if you draw the Bode plot, we have a magnitude value, we have a phase angle value, and we plot with respect to frequency. So suppose if you plot magnitude, this is basically the angle. This is angle with respect to omega frequency. This is amplitude modulus with respect to frequency. Then you see the frequency, this your magnitude part, since it is inversely proportional to omega, it means magnitude is a frequency dependent, isn't it or not? It is frequency. But if you see this expression, no omega term is there. It means if you are going to plot this part with respect to frequency, it remains a constant. It means at every frequency, the phase angle is constant. It means it is having the constant phase angle. It means that is what is the property of a fractional element. And that is what is called, it is a constant phase element. So this is the element, it is having constant phase for the entire frequency range. Okay. This value of phase angle, it depends on the values of alpha. In case of a pure capacitor, I have told you, alpha is basically your, suppose if you take minus 1, so it is going to be pi, this is basically, if you take alpha is equal to 1, so this is minus pi by 2. If take alpha is equal to minus 1, it becomes pi by 2. If alpha is 0, then it becomes 0. So it means, in case of a resistance, what is the phase angle between voltage and current? We know this is 0. In case of a capacitor, it is minus pi by 2. In case of an inductor, it is plus pi by 2. It means it is a limiting situation. Just replacing values of alpha, we are having different phase angle, and that phase angle become constant, remains for the entire range. But this is not the case for this. It means if you want to see the property of a fraction order element, its phase angle is frequency independent, but its amplitude is frequency dependent. So these two things you have to remember in case of a fractional order element. Phase angle is independent of the frequency. Amplitude, it is dependent on the frequency. Okay. Do you think this type of structure available in real world? This is the things, but many natural phenomena, it has been shown that they have fractional behavior. It means for a certain frequency range, it is showing the constant phase angle for the frequency, but amplitude is changing with respect to frequency. It means naturally, this type of devices or phenomena is present. But in real time, still people are trying to make a device something like, so because we know resistance values, we can fabricate, capacitance we can fabricate, inductance we can fabricate, we have lab in the lab, but do we have fractional element in our lab? Never we find this thing, because still it is difficult to fabricate. So it, suppose if you have a transmission line, you're already familiar with transmission line, infinite transmission line, when you have studied the two-port network, hybrid parameter model, transmission line model, we have studied different type of model in case of a two-port network. So suppose this is the infinite transmission line. Then we know the equivalent impedance. This is given by the expression square root ZA into ZB, where ZA, it is the this part of the impedance, and this is ZB, this is the, and this is basically infinite line. It means it is composed of this part, infinite number. Then this, it means this a part, it is connected in cascade form, one after the other, and it is leading to the infinite transmission line. And if we take Z is equal to R and Z is equal to 1 by SC in case of a transmission line, we know that this one we can represent by resistance and inductance, and this is by capacitor. But since it is a conductor, so inductance contribution is negligible. We can take, but resistance we cannot neglect. So we can tell Z is equal to R and ZB is equal to 1 by SC. If you put this value here, then what become? It becomes root over S by 2, S to the minus 1 by 2. Now imagine if you replace S by J omega, then what happened? It means this is also, if you see, it means its impedance is depends on root over R by S omega, but phase angle is 1 by 2. It means alpha is equal to minus 1 by 2. It is basically a 45 degree angle. It means this transmission line, it is a fractional order element with order, with a phase angle minus 45 degree angle. Not, it is basically pi by, so see, because pi by 2 into 1 by 2. So giving your 45 degree angle. It means we can make, or you can say it is a half order system. So we can, if we have this type of structure in real life, then we can get the fractional order property. But it is very difficult to make a such a structure. We have to make the structure of infinite length. It means in real time, suppose if we take this type of element, number of elements if we take it. Then for a certain range, we can get the fractional order behavior. Because this is basically, this infinite transmission line, it is showing constant phase behavior for the entire frequency range, isn't it? But suppose if you take 5 or 10, this type of element cascaded together, then it also can show fractional behavior, but for a limited frequency range. Because as we're going to sacrifice the number of elements, we're going to lose the frequency range property also, isn't it? So we'll see. So this type of system, we can call it is a half-order system, OK? Then this is another situation. This is called, suppose in case of electrolyte, if you are placing two electrodes, OK? Then suppose water, you are putting two electrodes, you are putting inside it. Then this structure, this cell, electrochemical cell, you can represent by this type of equivalent circuit. So in this equivalent circuit, there is a one element that is represented by W. This is called Warsbar impedance. This Warsbar impedance, it is again a half order system. It means this fractional order behavior, it can also be observed if we have a electrolytic cell. If you put the two electrodes in a electrochemical cell where suppose it may be the water or some polar molecules are there. So that even the viscoelasticity mechanism, that can also be represented by fraction. This is basically a fraction order element. So this is a real phenomena where we can observe the fractional order behavior. Okay, but still we don't have these things in real life. So fractional capacitor, we can represent by Q by S to the power alpha. If your fractional inductor, it should be S to the power minus alpha. Then it becomes fractional inductor, okay? Or if you take S alpha is equal to 0, it becomes fractional resistor, or simply it is a resistant. This is basically how, if you take this one Kron approximation is taken, so if you are going to have this type of element, integer order approximation of fractional transfer function. It means the transfer function of fractional order, we can represent it by integer order transfer function in this way. Okay, now there is another important thing is that effectively a fractional order transfer function is approximated by integer order transfer function with high order. It means if we have an element which is having fractional order, maybe alpha is minus 1 to 1, 0.5, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.7. Okay, if you want to represent this situation by integer order element, then we have to represent the same thing by highest order. Then it can be approximate. When both things can be equivalent. This is what we want to say this thing. This is basically another structure is there. We will see. This is one very important paper. It was, I think, the professor S. C. Dr. Rai. Still, I remember when I became lecturer in Jamia, Millia. He came as a visitor nominee during my selection committee. And he works on circuits. He's a very well-known man throughout the world. Now he's a retired person. He proposed this concept in 1967. And this paper, it can be treated as a seminal sort of paper. He has given the how a fractional order element can be realized and what is the properties. He has basically given this one. And he has also mathematically proved different circuit structure. Suppose this is one structure. This is called RC ladder network. This is identical same RC lattice network. And he has mathematically shown that suppose if you take this structure, this is for a certain frequency range. This is basically phase angle, and this is the frequency. This plot, it is taken from that paper. This is phase angle. This is the frequency. You see, this is basically the plot of phase angle versus frequency for different number of elements. Suppose here C1, R1 layer, C2, suppose you have only three sections you have considered. In case you have taken 9 sections or 10 sections, because this is the infinite sections are there. If you consider suppose 10 sections or 20 sections, then its fractional behavior is changing. So he has told this is basically the situation for n, it is not visible, maybe around n is equal to 10. So if you have this type of structure, 10 section, then for a certain range, it is behaving a constant phase behavior. This is another structure that is called infinite cross RC ladder network. I think in circuit we have studied different type of network. This is in fact ladder network. Of this structure, it is going to up to infinity. And in this case also, the impedance Z as represented by 1 by RC is to the one, it means the RC ladder network cross, this is also a fractional order element with alpha 0.5 and theta minus 45 degree angle. It means if you have make this type of structure in real life with infinite number of elements, then we can get a fractional order behavior with fractional order 0.5 and theta is minus 45 degree angle. But it is impossible to make in real life of infinite section. So again, if we take some elements, then if we try to study the behavior, so for a certain frequency range, it shows fractional order behavior. This is the thing. So it is possible to obtain different values of alpha using cross RC ladder network. It means in practice, in real time, we can realize this type of structure in real life, but the circuit becomes very bulky and impractical. So this is basically the limitation from implementation point of view. We can make, but it becomes bulky and impractical. So this is another structure. This is called domino ladder network. What is that? RC0, R1C1, R2C2, RC3. So it means parallel combination of resistance and capacitor. And again, it is going to extend up to infinite number. Okay. And what? How to select the value? Because this is R0, this is R1, this is R2, this is R3, this is R4. So it can go up to infinity. Similarly, C0, C1, C2, it can go to up to infinity. So in this situation, the value of R1, R2, C selected by using this expression, Rj is equal to Jj to the power minus j into R0. Take some values of R0 and fulfill this equation. Cj is equal to G capital G to the power J C0, where Gj capital G is greater than 0, where this G and capital G, this is basically geometric progression value. It means we know geometric progression 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32. This way you have to, it means if you take this is 1K, this should be 2K, this should be 4K, this should be 8K, this should be 16K, this should be 32K, this should be 64K. Similarly, this on 1 nanofarad, this is 2 nanofarad, this is 4 nanofarad, this is 8 nanofarad. If you do this way, this is called geometric progression. If you select the values of component in this geometric progression fashion, in that case, we can have the impedance for this network is given by Za is called 1 by Cf s to the power alpha, where alpha lies within 0 to 1. Okay? And where alpha is given by 1 minus V, where V is ln G by ln GG. So what is G? This is a geometric progression value. Okay? You can start value. So then 1 by Cf is given by this expression. And okay. Now I have given on practical realization. I got this from the books of, again, Dr. Korovi Vishas, recently published 2011, IT Circuit Device and System. He has tried to realize the fractional order element, and he has realized fractional order integrator. We know integrator, differentiator, op amp as integrator, op amp as a differentiator. She has given the concept and fractional order integrator, how it can be made. So suppose what is there? This is a op amp. If it's an integrator, we use a capacitor. If it is a differentiator, which capacitor here? This is the resistance. Okay? So this is an integrator. This part is just to reverse the phase angle. So you have a negative, if you see the output, it becomes minus. So again, you take the minus, it becomes plus. So that is why the V naught transfer function, overall transfer function, that is V naught S by V in S, this can be given by Q by R in S to the power alpha. Suppose this is a fraction order element where it is by Q by S to the power alpha. And this is your R in. So what will be the value here? Q by R in S to the power alpha. Isn't it? And since this value is 1, so just only negative part will be eliminated. So it, this transfer function, it becomes Q by R in S to the power alpha for this fraction or integrator. Now replacing S by J omega, what we can get? This is V naught J omega by V in J omega. This is by Q by R in J omega to the power alpha. This can be written as Q by R in omega to the power alpha into E to the power minus J alpha pi by 2. Okay? So what is this value? This is the amplitude. This, what is the value? This is the angle, we know. In this, in our normal mathematics, so this is the amplitude, or this is, suppose here it is written as a gain. So gain is Q by R into the omega alpha, and phase difference is minus alpha pi by 2 radian. So if we're going to plot this response curve, gain versus frequency, and also phase angle versus frequency, so what type of behavior you can observe? It will give the, this will be frequency dependent, but this will be frequency independent. It depends only on the values of alpha. So if you have a different values of alpha, we have a different frequency, phase angle value, and but it remains constants. Let us see the behavior. Here basically I have taken from the that paper I have taken it. What is there? He has basically implemented RC cross RC ladder network for different values of RC and N. In fact, I have also tried to simulate this circuit using some multisim software. And I also got the similar type of result. I mean, so I have tried to simulate this one. So what she has taken, it is a cross RC ladder network. R, C, and N, N is number of cross element, cross section. R and C ka jo ek ek element ko cascade form mein connect kiya gaya hai, to kitna number of section hai. This is basically, it is indicating. Suppose, because in case of a cross R, RC ladder network, R and C values are same. Wahan pe value is not changing. All the values, component section value will be same. Okay. Suppose first case he has taken 5, number of section 5, R is 22 kilo ohm, C is 0.47 kilo ohm, and frequency range she has found 100 hertz or 300 kilohertz, and this is Q is 1.93, this one, alpha is 0.48 plus one 0.02 and point. It means theory, this is alpha T, this is the theoretical value of fractional exponent, and alpha, this is the real value she has obtained. It means she has fabricated a cross RC ladder network by using these component values, and number of section is 5. Then here she has tested over a frequency range from maybe 100 hertz to 1 megahertz. She has done the testing, and she has found only for this range that network behavior showing the cross, meaning constant phase behavior. As I have told you, if you take an infinite section, then it will be for the entire frequency range. From 0 to infinity, you will get the constant phase behavior. But she has compromised. She has taken only n section. It means your range is going to be different, and it should be limited, and that exactly what she has got. This is only this to this. Then she has also taken some other value. It means this factor, again, 22 kilo ohm, now value is different. This is also going to same. But now the range is getting limited. Okay, I doubt this should be, I think, around 1 to 300 hertz. Maybe I have to check it. But this is again 100 to only 1.5 kilo, 15 hertz is there. What is the angle? 0.49. This is 0.5. Theoretical 0.5 is 0.4. It means it is close to 0.5. This is the real value. This is the theoretical value. Then she has done the same test using the domino ladder network for different values of RC and N. Domino, I have told you, what is domino? RC, RC, RC. It is not cross-connected, okay? So domino ladder network, you know, G value is 2, small g is 2, geometric progression. Isn't it, I have told you, geometric progression, G is 2, capital G is 4, R naught is 200 kilo ohm, C naught is 4 microfarad, and number of section is 7. And she has given the name D1 is D1. She has found the constant phase angle range 100 hertz to 3 kilohertz. And Q is this one. Value is 0.36 plus minus 0.05. Theoretically, for this structure, you will get the alpha value, fractional order, 0.33. But actually, the value got is 0.36. Similarly, when you are taking the same number of section 9, then what happened, 100 hertz to, again, almost same. But now, the value is almost close to the theoretical value. It means number of section increases. So you are going to get more accurate fractional value according to the, with respect to the real one. This is, in fact, another one. So this way, I mean, fractional order integrator, it has been verified experimentally using fractional order element. Let us see the frequency behavior, because we want to see this one. So cross RC ladder network, RC N number cross element is there, N5 values different that already have shown in the table. So this is the impedance value with respect to frequency. As I have told you, impedance value magnitude should change with respect to frequency, but phase angle should remain constant. As you see, for this here, we get it means it was mistake was there. It is 300 hertz only, 0.3 kilohertz. You see, it become almost constant. But after that, it is changing, isn't it? It means for a limited range, it is showing the constant phase behavior. Why? Because number of sections are lesser. Only 9 sections are there or 5 sections are there. This is the structure for domino ladder. It means here also, amplitude is continuously changing with respect to frequency. But phase angle almost constant. Almost it is constant. Up to, make say, up to 10 kilohertz, this is constant. But not for the entire range. This is what is the things try to establish. This is another structure. This is basically this fractal and fractans. It is self-symmetric repeated structure. Dimension non-integer. Fractans, self-symmetric repeated structure, order less than 1. Okay? It means it is just like, suppose it is a, first start this one pores are there. Okay? It is basically the identical structures are there. Then this part, it is broken into two parts, this one and this one, and this gap. Then again, this is repeated. So it is basically the self-symmetric repeated structure, dimension non-integer. This type of structure shows fractional order behavior. It means if we can make a porous structure in a material, then we can observe the fractional order behavior. So this is what is the importance of fractional order element. And this is, in fact, the impedance plot. This is the magnitude. So what is happening? This magnitude is changing, but over a only minus plus minus 2 degree variation is there. But it almost, you can say, constant. Because this peak, it is 40, suppose 59, and this is your 61. So only plus minus 2 degree variation is there. So within this, a phase angle is changing. This is structure. How equivalent you can represent? This is the K is 0. This is K 1. It means this is the R and C. R and C become two part, this one or this one. Then it again it is broken two part, again it is broken two part, this is again broken two part, it means ultimately it can extend up to infinity. And this structure for the entire range, it can show the fractional behavior. This is some people that have recently tried to fabricate the fractional device using electrochemical process. This is one structure it is given, proposed by G. W. Bohannon, 2008. Journal of Vibration Control, and he has established that for a frequency from this to this, it is almost showing the constant phase behavior, and this is basically your amplitude that is changing. So this electrochemical structure, we can get this type of thing. This is the structure that is given by Dr. Korobi Vishas and this group, and Professor Siddhartha Sen, it was published in 2006, and this is the structure they have fabricated, and they showed that this device, it is behaving as a fractional order element. And what is there? That I am going to explain to you. So what is there? This is basically a double-sided copper cladded polymer substrate. You know the PCB making substrate? It is double-sided. Suppose this is a substrate, this side also copper, this side also copper. So double-sided copper cladded PCB she has taken, they have taken, and then they have deposited insulating film of acrylic. I have told you yesterday, and last time, acrylic, it is an insulator. It is used for making capacitor. It is, isn't it? We use acrylic, or it's called perspex. But in our household, with different application, we use perspex. Maybe it is just like a plastic material. Acrylic is a plastic material, or it is a polymer material. Okay. So basically, PMM, its full name, polymethyl methacrylate. Acrylic, we say short, but in actually, it is polymethyl methacrylate. So this is in fact, so basically, they have taken one copper cladded polymer PCB substrate, then they have deposited porous PMA film on both sides. And this is the two contacts. So simple device, isn't it? Take only copper cladded polymer substrate, PCB, or polymer also you can take it. It is available, easily available to make a circuit, isn't it or not? And you just deposit a insulating film of acrylic. By they have made by solution method using some polyamide flakes available in the market, polyamide powder available in the market. You just make a solution using chloroform. You can make a solution and you just dip. You can get this structure. Sorry, then it is epoxy glass, but in PCB, if you see the material is epoxy glass. So it is having copper cladding, black one, black is still copper cladding. And this one is basically porous PMA film. And then they dip, put this stick, this is a stick, put in a polarizing medium, means water. Yes, water is a polarizing medium, okay? And then they have tried to study the phase behavior and amplitude behavior. So this is basically different type of sample they have taken. One reading with, suppose, polar medium with pH value 4, with pH value 7, equivalent 9.2, you are just imagining pH 7, it is basically the pH of water, isn't it or not? pH 9.2, it becomes basic in nature. pH less than 7, it becomes acidic in nature, isn't it? So it is basically having polar molecule, but acidity of this become change according to it means it has, they have taken different pH value solution, and then they have tried to find, see how beautiful it is, isn't it? From maybe from 20 kilohertz to 200 kilohertz, this behavior exactly constant, phase angle exactly constant. So simple device, but it is showing the constant phase behavior. It is, this is basically the real device. So simple, but it is giving the behavior. Similarly, so this is another, make for a certain frequency range, but again, it is not for the entire range. As I have told you, that this device, it is basically for, it need record infinite section. So why it is there? We'll see why. What is the reason behind it? As I have told you, this is basically the structure after PMMA coating. This is the structure before PMMA. It means copper film, it is having this structure, but when you deposit the PMMA, polymethyl methacrylate solution, thin film, it is becoming porous structure, isn't it or not? It means there is a porous structure over the copper film, and copper it is used as a metal, it is electrode. So it means when you are dipping this stick in a polarizing medium, ionic medium, then what happens? Through the pores, water come in contact with the electrodes or copper. Okay, so this is basically, so say what is happening here? Diffusion of ions through porous PMMA or alumina during the charge transfer process can be modeled as an infinite RC network. As I've told you, that we need to have a RC network which should be of infinite size. Okay, then it will show the constant phase behavior. So you see this structure showing the constant phase behavior. So it means when you are making pores and when it is coming in contact with the electrode, then it is also behaving as like an infinite RC network, and that is why it is showing the constant phase behavior. So okay, there is another paper. They have shown suppose it is a solid and it is basically the pores, then it is forming this type of equivalent circuit. Resistance, capacitance, again resistance, again capacitance. It is just like a RC network. Okay, so it means these pores, suppose here this is basically you can say barrier layer. This is a hole. This through this hole, water molecule can get into the electrode, but this is the barrier. It means it can form a capacitor. It can form a resistance. And it is having infinite number of pores, so infinite number of RC section. So it means this. That is why they are trying to explain this phenomena in that way. So for porous nature of surface, there is a distribution of time constraints. It means why it is happening. It means if you see the infinite section of RC network, we are having resistance and capacitance. So it means its time constant is distributing nature. What is time constant? R into C. So as R and C value is changing, time constant is changing. So there is a distribution of time constant in case of a infinite RC network. So similarly, it is happening here also. It means the porous nature of the surface, insulin surface, it gives a distribution of time constant. This time constant depends on the pore size, ionic concentration, and area of contact. This is basically the thing. This is giving the idea of sensing application. It means this distribution time constant, it depends on pore size, it depends on ionic concentration, and it depends on area of contact. So if you can vary the pore size, constant phase behavior can be changed. If you can take different ionic concentration, constant behavior can be changed. If you change the area of contact, we can have a different constant phase behavior. So just in case of sensing application, suppose if you want to sense the this in case of milk, they have used basically ionic concentration is going to change it. Suppose if there is milk adulteration, suppose if we add water to the pure milk, so what happens? Ionic concentration is changing. So in that case, your behavior will change, and that exactly they have done to analyze the quality of milk that we use. Okay, so it means diffusion of ions through the pores can be equivalently represented by infinite transmission line similar to the RC. This is the things that you have to keep in your mind. Why this porous structure on polyamide, on copper clad, showing the constant phase behavior? Why? Basically, the diffusion of ions through infinite pores can be equivalently represented by infinite transmission line similar to RC network. As I told you, the infinite RC network, it will show the constant phase behavior. This is the structure. They're so simple. What is there? This is, in fact, they have also made the similar structure using some carbon nanotubes. This is, in fact, we need a material which can give the porous structure. So pores we can make in a different way. First, they have started with polymethacrylate, then they have shifted to carbon nanotube. Why they have shifted? Basically, when the Professor Sen, he came in our IEEE Indicon conference, he has told one challenge to us for this research. He has told that PMM giving excellent reading, but this material showing drift with respect to time, and that is discouraging us. So then it means that it is very excellent behavior, showing excellent reading, everything. But what happened? The PMMA material, it shows drift with respect to time. It means today you are taking reading, after 1 month, it for the same situation, reading changes. So it is the drift due to aging that is creating problem for them. So they are trying to obtain some solution in a different way. And this is one attempt. Then they have tried with carbon nanotube. We know carbon nanotube, it is another excellent material. So many research throughout the world, people are telling the CNT can replace silicon technology. It thinks will be very small. If you can make a CNT-based device, your mobile phone or computer, you can put it in a pocket. You can fold it and you can put it in a pocket. People think in that way. It means maybe it has the potential, but it's still not, some issues are there. So they have also tried with carbon nanotube. This is basically the copper poly PCB, copper cladded, and this is the film. So those film, it is having the porous structure. And then they have tested. It is an impedance analyzer, LCR meter. You have to measure L, Z, and theta. Z theta means kind of, Z is basically phase, amplitude of the impedance, and theta is the phase angle over a wide frequency. So this instrument, we have the provision to vary the frequency from maybe 100 hertz to 1 megahertz. In my lab also we have on equipment, you have seen LCR impedance analyzer, where we can vary frequency from 40 hertz to 110 megahertz. But we do not need this much frequency. Maybe 100 hertz to 1 megahertz is more than enough for testing the behavior of the device, constant phase behavior. So this is basically, they have tested it, and they got this reading. You see how beautiful it is. Constant phase behavior, isn't it? 6 hours, as I have told you. It means they are now, what is this reading? This is basically the drip due to aging. Age of response curve, we normally call it is a drip due to aging. So first they have done the testing 6 hours after making the film, then after 24 hours, after 1 day, then again after 2 days, then after 5 days, then after 14 days. It means they have tested the same sample for different time. First day, second day, third day, fifth day, 14 day. Then it found that all the curves are almost close to each other. It means this device with carbon nanotube based fractal, it is giving the almost drip free reading that they are not able to get it with polymethyl methyl acrylate. This is what is the material part. You have to explore, you know, as I've told you, if there is a drift in sensor output, it is not usable for us. We can't do signal conditioning. We cannot use for real-time application. This is one of the important issues, even more issues than sensitivity that we always talk about. Some other people, they have also tried to make a fractals on silicon substrate. They have made this type of stuff. What is there? This is basically, you could say, crack, isn't it? So this crack, once you're making a crack on the silicon substrate, it is again forming the structure of arsenic network. And it is can give the, so this is only the zone, CPA zone. See, they have tested, this is the structure, they have made it. They have tested for over a wide frequency. Only this zone, it is showing the constant phase. Rest, it is not showing. So it means if you want to obtain the constant phase behavior, your frequency should be limited on this, in this zone only. Otherwise, you cannot get the constant phase behavior. So many applications possible. We now are familiar with what is fractals, what is the properties, how to fabricate, what issue you have to keep in mind. Okay, now we have to use this device for different type of application. And we will see what beautiful things we can get using the fractional order element. So first application, I will mostly concentrate on sensor part. This is basically that we have done in our lab. So we have started our journey after, you can say, 15 years. 2003, I have just got the stick that Dr. Vishas, she was telling us. But after 15 years, we start doing the same thing, but in a different way. I mean, structure is same. It is, we're using aluminum oxide. They have used polymethyl methyl acrylate, and then your carbon nanotubes. But we have aluminum oxide. So again, why I'm using aluminum oxide? Because it is a very robust, it is a rock. Rock means it does not react with the atmosphere easily. So it means we can get much better drip response. It means reading will be more stable with respect to time. And we can also make a nanostructure, because we need to have a nanostructure, nanopores, and that we can create easily aluminum oxide, it is the material which is used for commercially to make a sensor. And it is available in the market, but not CNT-based sensor. For PMMA, as I have told, it is also having certain issue. So we have tried to replace PMMA by using the aluminum oxide. Okay, and this is the structure that we are having. What is there? First, we have taken an aluminum substrate. Then over the substrate, we have deposited aluminum oxide film, nanostructure film. Then we have deposited electrode. But here electrode, you can say it is an interdigital electrode. I have told you, structure, it may be parallel plate, it may be interdigital plate, or metal will be throughout the entire surface, or not throughout the entire surface. Then over this electrode, there is another metal film. So there is a film, electrode, then film. See, it is just like a structure that they have, because they have used a copper cladding. Over the copper, there is a film of insulating film. So here also, suppose this is a copper, this is insulating, this side is also insulating. Okay, and so we have taken aluminum substrate, alumina M, it should be aluminum substrate, nanoporous, L2O3 film deposition, deposition of interdigital electrode, nanoporous L2 film deposition again, sintering film, including the electrode at 450 degrees centigrade temperature. This is basically the nanostructure. See, this is scanning rate, is scanning resolution is 100 nanometer. Okay, 100 nanometer, you see we can get small black dots. This black dot is basically the pores. So these pore size is very small, less than 10 nanometer. But in case of PMMA, they have found the pore size is in micrometer. So micrometer and nanometer, 1,000 times difference, isn't it? So nanometer pores, 1,000 times smaller than micrometer pores. So in their structure, they have taken pores of micrometer size. In my case, we have taken the pores of nanometer size. And that gives a difference in our response also. We'll see. So the properties of CPE, it is a constant phase element for sensing humidity. This is one application that I have told you that constant phase element or fractional element, it can be used for sensing application. So one typical application that we have done, it is for sensing humidity. So it depends on length of the sensor, which immerses in the polarizing medium, contact area in the polarizing medium, and ionic concentration. It means you are having you take a beaker, put some polar solution, let's take a water only, because it is a polar medium, and insert your sensor. So sensor, the contact area, it depends on the constant phase behavior. It depends on the contact area of the sensor to the solution. It also depends on the pore size. It also depends on the ionic concentration. So humidity sensor, we have dip in length is constant, contact area is constant, concentration of ions varies. So it is the application we want to go for humidity sensing. So contact area, I mean it is exposed area is also constant, or you can say dip in length is also constant. And concentration, it means in case of a humidity sensing, water is a polar molecule. The ionic concentration of ions, concentration of ions varies with increase in concentration. It means as you're going to increase the humidity, more water molecule will come, so more ionic concentration will be there, because water is basically having lots of ions, isn't it? So this is, okay. Now for in case of properties, in case of a second application, this is for CPE, for liquid level detection. As I told you, last time also we have explained on design of capacitive transducer for measuring length of liquid. And we have taken the liquid maybe non-conducting and conducting both. Okay, so this one application is possible to measure the dipping length of a polarizing nature. Suppose you want to measure the length of a water in a tank. Every house is having water tank, isn't it? And maybe suppose your big oil tanks are there. It is very challenging to measure the level of the water, because, or you can say oil. And different techniques are developed to measure the length of the oil tank, or level of the oil or water, you can say. for different industrial application. Okay, so this is one of the important application. So it can be used for, we have used for liquid level detection. So in this case, dip in length and contact area vary. But concentration of ion is constant. Because in this case, we are not varying the ionic concentration because it depends on three parameters. So we have to do something constant also. So concentration of ion is constant, but dip in length and contact area varying. So we are basically varying the dip in length. It is assumed that liquid has similar ionic concentration. We are assuming that liquid having a similar ionic concentration. It means that suppose we want to measure the level of water. The level of water, it is a constant medium. So it is having a constant ionic concentration. Suppose you are using some other application also. Even if you want to measure the quality of milk, pure milk having constant ionic concentration. Okay. This is what is the behavior of study. So we have studied the behavior from 100 hertz to 5 megahertz. Okay. Only in this zone, it is showing the constant phase behavior. This is the phase angle, and this is the beta in fractional order. So what is happening? Fractional, it is changing, but this is the order is. So it is what is happening here. For a fixed RH level, suppose 90% RH level, it is showing the constant phase behavior over a certain range. Over, as I have told you, it is not for the entire range. For a certain range, it is showing constant phase behavior. But as concentration of RH level is changing, then there is a shift in phase angle. See, this one 96% top, this one is 4%. It means from 4 to 96% RH, there is a change in some angle of nearly 30 degree angle change is there. Isn't it or not? So we draw a perpendicular here. This is 90 degree. It means when 4% RH, you can say no ionic concentration is there, minimum ionic concentration. So it is just like a pure capacitor. Pure capacitor means angle should be minus 90 degree. Okay, as we're increasing the concentration of RH level, it is having more lossy in nature. So as lossy in nature, phase is shifting toward this one. So if phase angle changes, then order should also change. But in case of pure capacitor, order is 1. In case of a, if order is changing, it becomes less than 1. So this is exactly what is happening. It is 1. It is coming decreasing. It goes down to maybe 0.67%. This is another study. So this is phase and order vary with percentage RH. This is in fact another study that we have done, because ultimately when we are going to give excitation to the sensor, we have to give some input voltage also. AC voltage with varying signal frequency. So we have taken different amplitude and keep the frequency constant. Then we have tried to study. So it has been found that input voltage varies from maybe 50 millivolt to 500 millivolt, but phase angle remains almost constant. It means the device does not have an effect on the amplitude of input voltage, but it is have effect only on the frequency. And this is what we want to get in. This is a study that we have made for repeatability. As I have told you, for any sensing device, we have to study sensitivity, we have to research repeatability, we have to obtain response time, recovery time, aging effect, temperature effect, all these things you have to determine. So this has been determined for these applications also. Okay, then this is called Nyquist plot. I think Nyquist plot, you're already familiar with. It is a three-dimensional plot. Bode plot, it is a two-dimensional plot. Amplitude versus frequency. Phase angle versus frequency. But Nyquist plot, it is a three-dimensional. Imaginary component of impedance, real component of impedance, and frequency. It is having three things. Imaginary component of impedance, real component of impedance, and frequency also there. It means same plot, it is having three information. It means we can get the information of three effects. So this is basically for frequency 100 hertz to this is imaginary part, this is real part, this is frequency 100 hertz to 5 megahertz. This is for higher RH level. So 70% RH to 96% RH. So what do you see? As you are going to increase the frequency, lower humidity, it is just like a curved line. But higher humidity, it is having two part. One part is semicircle, one part is straight line. Okay, this behavior, it is giving the ideas of what will be the equivalent circuit for this type of structure. So that is why people go for Nyquist plot to obtain, because this is a device. And ultimately, as an electrical engineer, we have to represent everything in terms of equivalent circuit. Because we want to see what is there in terms of RC and L, isn't it? So you want to get this one, this is the plot that can help you. So what is happening? This is one straight line. So it means in this curve, it is having two parts. One is curve, one is semicircle. And this is one possible equivalent circuit. This is resistance, capacitance. So normally this semicircle part, it is represented by R and C in parallel. And this straight line part, it is represented by, you can say, a constant phase behavior. Okay. So this is in fact, in this equivalent circuit, it is having some part is R and C in parallel, and some part is having your constant phase behavior also. And it is the combination of the two. This is in fact the response curve for phase angle response from this to this. And one interesting thing that I want to explain to you, that you see, imagine in this case, you are getting the phase behavior at higher frequency, isn't it? What is the frequency here? Here to here, it is 2 megahertz to 5 megahertz, isn't it? So constant phase behavior in my application, it is giving above 1 or 1.5 megahertz frequency. But in their application, their grating frequency lower, maybe 100 kilohertz to 300 kilohertz. So why it is happening? This is basically because of the pore size. So in their application, pore size is micrometer. In my application, pore size is 10 nanometer. So if you are having a smaller pore size, we can get the constant phase behavior, but at a higher frequency. So if you want to get constant phase behavior for this application, lower frequency range, what we have to do? We have to increase the pore size. And that's what we are trying to do. This is what is our next work in our lab, to increase the pore size of this aluminum oxide of our sensor. Then we want to again study how the frequency range is changing or not. And ultimately, we have to make a system. When we have to make a system, we have to make an interface electronic circuit, and we have to get a voltage signal. That it means the phase angle change, it should be converted into a voltage signal. So we need a circuit which is called phase detector. So in this case, the system, it is changing frequency. So we'll select a excitation frequency where the sensor is showing constant phase behavior, and then we'll measure the phase angle change. So this is what is it, you see, this is a beautiful circuit that we have also proposed in the paper. What is there? This is two op-amp is there. This op-amp is nothing, it is a buffer, you can say, and this is a inverter. So what will be the signal here? It is Vi. So here the signal Vi is, it should be here there also. You see, I have taken excitation frequency 1 megahertz. I can take 1 kilohertz also. Why I have taken 1 megahertz? Because our constant phase behavior, it shows that higher frequency. And that is I have taken it is 1 megahertz. Okay, so 1 megahertz, and what happened in the op-amp, if you see its characteristic, it is having some gain bandwidth product. And that information gives what is the frequency range for the op-amp, because op-amp phase angle also will change according to the frequency, output signal phase angle change. So this simple modification of the circuit, it has been reported in one paper I taken. They have shown that if you have this type of structure, this signal or this signal maintain 180 degree out of phase over a wide frequency up to 2 megahertz. My requirement is 1 megahertz, and that is I have taken this structure. Then it is a CP element sensor. This is a fixed resistance. So what will happen? Here there will be phase shift, isn't it or not? Phase angle will change according to the humidity, and that signal is converted into square wave signal. Okay, this is another signal, reference signal. It is also converted, it is a comparator. What is a comparator? It is a zero crossing detector. So we are converting sinusoidal signal into a square wave voltage signal. Then we are giving to a, what is the name of this IC? This is called exclusive OR gate, JOR gate, hai na? XOR gate. In case of XOR gate, what is the, if you see the truth table, what is that? If 01 high, 10 high, 110, 000, it means if the two signals, if there is a phase difference, only then it will give the high output, and that what we want, because we have to measure the phase difference. So what happened? This, you see, this is the actual waveform. This is the circuit we have implemented on breadboard, then taken the waveform on CRO, and CRO is giving this wave. See what is happening? The two signal, this is the reference one. The reference to change nahi hoga. But this one is phase amplitude, both is changing. We want to detect the phase. So you see the peak is different. Isn't it? There is a phase difference between the output and input signal. And ultimately, this is a, this part is called low pass filter. So we are getting a very fine square wave signal, which is basically, this is the output. This is the edges of the two square wave signal. And that edges is converted into DC by passing through a low pass filter RC. Okay, so we are having a here DC voltage. So this is the phase shift. First I have measured the phase shift by using the CRO. So phase shift versus RH. And this is the response curve. If you see, for lower RH, this sensor does not give response. So it means the sensor that we have developed for based on this principle, this does not work for low humidity. Why? Because in low humidity, ionic concentration is lower. And this sensor is totally based on ionic concentration. So that is why phase shift is not there. So as we're going to increase the humidity, ionic concentration increases, and we're going to get a good response that we have gotten. But then I have done another testing. As I have told you, that humidity sensor, it is humidity, it is having a very wide range. PPM, PPB, parts per trillion to RH level. And some application, we have to measure humidity in percent, 100%. 100% RH means it is just like water. Even the atmospheric humidity, if goes above 95% RH, we will find it becomes water-like situation. Okay, so in when humidity becomes very high, then there will be water condensation on the sensor. Then most of the sensor get damaged. Otherwise, it becomes short because it is having two electrodes. So water is just like conducting body. If two electrodes, they're coming. If the water is coming between the two electrodes, it gets short, it will not work. And particularly, the commercial polymer-based sensor, it cannot work above 97% RH. It will be damaged. And last time, if that time also I have told you. Okay, so what happened? So in case of a high humidity above 98% RH, water condensation sensor will be damaged. But this sensor, since it is based on metal oxide, and it is based on dipping time, it will not be damaged. And that's why we have told in the paper, this is suitable for very high humidity measurement. I think we are all saturated. We should take a break first, because our mind also gets saturated after some time. Maybe at least after one hour, it gets saturated. Saturated means we are not able to listen with concentration. We lose our concentration. So, thoda sa chai peene ke baad, once again, assemble there. Okay, so we should start once again from here. I have explained to you how this circuit is working. I have explained to you how we got this reading, phase difference with respect to humidity, which is excited at a frequency of 1 megahertz. Why I have selected 1 megahertz, I have explained to you. This is the actual reading that you obtain on CRO screen, snapshot. And this is another reading that you have taken just to test our sensor, whether it can tolerate the humidity of 100% RH or not. As I have told you that even last time also, if you remember, the sensor which has operating range from 0 to 100% RH, it is costlier sensor. But 5 to 95% RH, cheap, only 500 rupees you have to pay. But if you want to go above 95% RH, up to 100%, you have to pay more money. Why? Because it is issues to maintain the sensor. Sensor get damaged. You need a special attention for fabricating those sensors. So in my application, I have also tried to test our sensor at 100% RH. As I have told you, 100% RH means, so I have told you that at 100% relative humidity, water will condense and it become liquid. So normally from 90 to 95% RH, waters remain in vapor form. You can say the water particles or water cluster remains in a vapor form in the atmosphere. Yes, you can say when it start forming, you can say condense on any surface. You will see if humidity is very high, it get condensed and it become liquid. If concentration is very high, because at this condition, your saturation vapor pressure become very high. Normally, humidity, how it is defined? It is the ratio of actual partial pressure of water to the saturation vapor pressure. In saturation vapor pressure means maximum humidity where there is a condensation will start. Okay, so it means at 100% RH, water condensation, so it will just become a liquid water and your sensor get normally damaged. So our sensor, it is based on aluminum oxide. And I have told you it is a rock material. So it means we are expecting that our sensor, it cannot be damaged at 100% RH. Okay, so that is why we have tested the sensor taking deep water and then dip the sensor at different length. So this is basically 1 centimeter dipping, 2 centimeter dipping, 3 centimeter dipping, and phase angle change with respect to different frequency. Suppose if you take, suppose 3 or 2 megahertz, so there is a change in phase angle also. That is happening, but it is, so again, as you see, that it is not perfectly showing the constant phase behavior. So what we are expecting, this is basically because of small pores, and that we can control by controlling the formation parameter. So what is the features of the sensor that we have used using fractional order? It is having insulation film, which is made of alumina, very robust material, so there is no drip problem. Very high humidity measurement, no problem due to water condensation. Conventional commercial polymer-based RH sensor cannot work above 97% RH. Water condensation damages the sensor. So very much suitable for fuel cell application for detecting flooding condition. You know, in fuel cell, people are trying to go for alternate green energy for driving our car using fuel cell. But it is an issue because in fuel cell, it is needed to detect humidity of flooding condition. I mean, concentration become very high. So that type of fabrication of that type of sensor for flooding condition is difficult. So this type of sensor can be used for those applications also. Another thing is that simple to fabricate at large scale at reduced cost. This is what is the feature. This is the sensor that we have fabricated in our lab. This is the first you have fabricated with double-sided, we have first, see, this is the experiment that we want to do in our lab. So first we have tried to repeat the experiment that IIT Kharagpur they have done. So first we have made sensor with polymethylmethacrylate film. This is the PME sensor. But we have done in a little different way. What we have done, we have taken some FTO substrate. FTO substrate is basically, this substrate, it cannot tolerate temperature above 200 degree centigrade temperature. It means your PCB, copper cladded PCB that you use for normally for making your circuit, it cannot tolerate temperature above 200 degree centigrade. So it means if you want to use this substrate for aluminum oxide, where we have to heat the substrate at 450 or 500 degree centigrade temperature, then it cannot be used, it will be damaged. So we have to use in a different way. So that what we have to do, use another substrate. It is a glass material. It is called fluorine tin oxide, glass substrate. This substrate, it is having already metal contact. So just, it is just like a copper cladding. It is having, but it is made of glass. And glass, it can tolerate temperature 450 easily, this FTO substrate. So that is why we have made the device not using copper cladded PCB, or we have used using the FTO glass substrate. We have also made sensor with alumina substrate. Alumina, it is called sapphire. This alumina, it can tolerate temperature up to 1100, 1200 degrees centigrade temperature also. I mean, normally alumina, it is made at 1000 degrees centigrade temperature heating. So it means the substrate, it can have the capability to tolerate temperature above 1000 degrees centigrade. And this sensor, it is made using gold electrode. And gold, it is made of gold paste. And gold paste, normally for metal, metallization, it should be heated at 900 degrees centigrade temperature. So we need a substrate which can withstand temperature above 1000 degrees centigrade, so that gold can be heated up to 900 degrees centigrade temperature. And that is how we have taken here. It is a constant phase element sensor with alumina, one with gold electrode. Then we have also tried to fabricate sensor with interdigital electrode, IDT. Why you have used IDT? Because if you are using this gold plating, it is a costly material. You know, imagine your gold paste, I mean, you just see 10 gram gold, it is costly 30,000 rupees. When I purchase gold paste of 30 gram as a paste form, I have to pay 1.5 lakhs. I have projects, I have purchased it. So it should be, we have to make some arrangement to reduce the consumption of gold. Sooner wasted. So I have tried in a different way. If it is IDT, what happens, it's here, gold requirement is 50% of this one. But we have to, so we should not lose the response characteristic of the device also. So I have also tried to make this type of structure, then make a CP behavior. So a different way we have tried to make the device in the lab, and we're trying to study the CP behavior for sensing application. This is what. This is one application I have used for water quality measurement. Today we are drinking water. We don't sure whether water that we drink is safe or not. You see, in these local areas, people sell water. 20 liters water, 20 rupees. They call it is RO water. Okay, but they, whatever they are telling, we are listening. Are you sure the quality of water they are supplying, it is safe for drinking? And sometime what happened, when I contacted this food supplying man, I have told him, you supply bisleri water for my guest. He's telling, sir, if you take bisleri water, it is not pure. They added impure water. So we have to believe him. We don't have any mechanism. And this is most happen. We used to drink water in railway station, bus station. So many places are there. But we are not sure about the quality of water. It may be impure. So we need to develop some simple device which can be used for detecting water quality. Normally, these RO people, they are mostly, you can say, layman. They don't know much about the thing. They use one meter that is called TDS meter. What is it? This is total dissolved salt. Basically, they try to measure the concentration of salt. Salt is ionic in nature. So based on the, it means they measure the conductivity of the water, and then if the conductivity TDS value, if it is more than 300, they say it is not safe for drinking. They try to check the water TDS value. If it is coming 100, 50, it is safe. It is, you can now drink. Okay, so they basically measure the conductivity of the water, and they try to assure us. But it is an issue. In India, we know that even we are drinking milk, but it is not pure. Previously, people add water, but now people add urea. You imagine. So if it is people adding water, at least it doesn't create health problem. But if it's adding urea, it is causing cancer. So we have to be careful. It is the job of our engineer to address this issue in a different way. So can you make some simple device which can be used for getting the information about the water quality? So this is one experiment we have tried to do with the constant phase element. So what is basically the, we are trying to measure the concentration of salt. And salt, it is ionic in nature. So when there is adulteration, what will happen? Ionic concentration will change. So accordingly, a constant phase behavior should also change. So we have fabricated a device. Make a device, I have taken pure bisleri water, pure DI water, pure rain water, pure tap water. Tap water we have in our university campus. We have also collected rain water. I have collected from my house. I have given it to my student. You just first filter it, because rain water is having some dust particle. We have to make it filter first. Then DI water we have in the lab. You know, this DI water, it's called deionized water. It is highly resistive water. Pure DI water, it resists 18 mega ohm. We have one instrument, some millipore equipment, but it is of low quality. Cost is lesser. Pure 18 mega ohm quality water producing DI water system, it costs around 3 to 4 lakhs. But the one that is with me, it is around 2 lakhs. And the quality of DI water is 14 mega ohm. So it is basically resistive. It means it doesn't have any ionic concentration. It means in that case, your constant phase should be almost 90 degree angle. We'll see what is happening. And pure bisleri, you always depend on bisleri. If you're traveling, we used to purchase bisleri only. Now we can drink the water in a tap water which is available in the railway station or bus station. So in a different way, try to find this one. This is the response curve. Again, I have told you that our sensor, it is based on aluminum oxide. It is having porous structure, but pore diameter is less than 10 nanometer. Okay, still we are not able to, we are trying to make the high water pores, so less than 10 nanometer pores, so we are expecting constant phase behavior at high frequency. Okay, so phase angle with respect to frequency, starting from 100 hertz up to 1 megahertz, around come to this point. Theek hai? This point, maybe it is basically 1000 kilohertz, it should be there. So 1 megahertz. So what is happening? This response curve, it is for pure DI water. What is pure DI water? It is totally free from ions. But it is not 100%. So what response is giving? What is the angle this? This is almost 90 degree angle. In which case we will get 90 degree angle? If it is pure capacitor, isn't it? Minus pi by 2. It means this information, it tells that it is basically ions free, isn't it? As we are going to change the type of water, rainwater, phase angle shifting. Then we are having pure bisleri shifting. Then tap water shifting. So there is a shift in phase angle. It means if the same device, it is giving a phase shift with respect to different type of water, so it means it can be used for detection of water quality also. And that is what is the application that we are trying to explore using the device for analyzing the quality of water. The next thing that, because it is the practice of businessmen, they want to quick money. For fat money, they have to earn by doing some adulteration. So we have to check. If there is adulteration, what happens? So what we have taken? We have taken pure bisleri water. Then we have added pure 25% impure water. Suppose boring water, or suppose your groundwater, it is having lots of ions. Some ions are very carcinogenic. Suppose arsenic is there, lead is there, mercury is there. You know, lead, mercury, oxygen, arsenic, these are metallic ion. They are carcinogenic. They cause cancer. You will find in India, those people who are living along the Ganga belt, river belt, they used to drink water of groundwater using tube oil. This area, there are many people, they are having this disease of arsenic contaminated diseases there. And you will find the WHO even, they have a special tube oil where so the arsenic can be filtered out. So this is basically the river belt. People are mostly affected because of arsenic, and it is cancer causing metal ion, lead, mercury, arsenic. These are the issues are there. So these are all metal ion. So we can, suppose metal ion is there, phase angle can change. So what we have taken? 25% addition. You see such a great change in frequency is there. It's just only 25% change is there. How much change is there? It is almost, you can say, 85 degree angle at 1 megahertz. It goes to, you can say, 40 degree. Then 50 degree phase angle change is there, just only by adding 25% adaptation. That's such a sensitive way we can detect very easily, isn't it? Then I have also tried, because it is a constant phase element, we have to measure fractional order value alpha. We also measure what is the phase angle. So then it is the thing for alpha. So alpha bisleri, alpha di, alpha range, alpha tap. So again, alpha di, it should be 1. 1 hona chahiye, because pure capacitating behavior. So phase is 90 degree, and it should be your value should be 1. So you see, this is giving 1 value. Then as you are changing, it is value is also changing. This is some error is there in the data. So this is how the water quality is basically changing the fractional order behavior of constant phase element. This is how the device can be used for water quality assessment. This is in fact the Q value. As I have told you, it is an amplitude and phase angle. Q should change with frequency. Theta should not change with frequency. So this is how frequency ke saath Q is changing for all the four different type of water. Okay, so this is the thing. Every time we are basically CP element, we are studying what is theta with respect to frequency for different type of water. We are studying Q amplitude with respect to frequency for different type of water. Okay. It is a comparison. Okay, this is basically the TDS meter reading. I have one TDS meter for my house RO system. I have brought it in the lab. I told, measure this TDS value, the water sample that you're taking. So this is your deionized water. You imagine it is value is 0. That reading, because why it is 0? Because it is ion free. It's ion free means no salt is there. So it should be, conductivity should be 0. So this is how it means almost it is close to 0. Then bisleri, 117, we can use it. This is rain. We know rain is also pure water. Sometimes if you remember, we used to clean the cloth with rain water. I remember in my child days, because why? It gives easily, we can get foam easily, isn't it or not? Because it is almost pure water. Okay? It means it can also give that TDS value somewhat lesser than this one, 40. Tap water. This is department tap water. In our department also, office, there is an RO system. And it is commercial branded RO system. We are also expecting good quality of water from the department RO system. And that is here, 170. But see, little bit of variation is there. According to this is the system. So, then we have tried to measure the phase different with respect to our system at different frequency. I have taken 40 hertz, 400 kilo hertz. This is minus 21.7. This is minus 42.0. This is minus 447.4. This is minus 22.9. You imagine, this is almost close. It is safe. They are claiming this is safe for drinking. This is deionized water without any salt. This is another pure form, less different. So this is how the things is given. And I have also tried to measure the pH value. This is 8.36, but I know, Bakshil, maybe our pH meter is not okay. Basically, your drinking water, it is neutral, isn't it? Value should be close to 7. So this is how it is a compare. It means that simple device, it can be used for big job, isn't it? We can make a system out of this constant phase device for testing the quality of water. We have to do the calibration. Make a system, do the calibration. Then I have done the same thing with PMM. I have told you, aluminum oxide, it gives constant phase behavior, but at higher frequency. At higher frequency, issue is there, making sealant conditioning circuit. It is difficult, little bit difficult, because op-amp that will use it is having some frequency behavior. And it is going to, if you're going to have a high frequency response of op-amp, cost is going to increase. Suppose you are using OP07, hardly it is 10 rupees. If you want to purchase one open TLC271, cost 1,200 rupees. If you want to go much better frequency response, it may go to 500 rupees. So it means if you want to make a system with low cost, we also have to keep in mind that frequency range should be lower. And then I have again make the same testing with PMMA. Polymethyl methacrylate. What is polymethacrylate? It is giving pores of larger size. Aluminum oxide give pore of lower size. Let us see the phase angle behavior. It is now goes down to 200 kilohertz. In my case, it gives above 1 megahertz, maybe at least 500 kilohertz above. But now it goes down to 200. This it means from low frequency, and how beautiful it is. You see the pure bisleri, it is almost coming to minus 85. It should be, because in this case, if you remember, we got minus 85 something there. This is almost coming to 90 degree, you can say. Then 20% adulteration. There is a signal change, and phase angle almost exactly constant. It is using the PMMM. Then I have also made using 10% adulteration. You see, 10% mein kya hona chahiye? Phase shift should be lower than 20%. Is it or not? So here in this case, your phase shift, it is basically goes below minus 70. It goes above 70. Isn't it or not? It will phase angle is also different for this one. Here phase shift is lower, here phase shift more. Here 20% adulteration, here 10% adulteration. It means as adulteration is changing, your phase shift also changing accordingly. And that what is desire for making a system. Then again, using comparison table, using CPA, 400, see, this is minus 83, minus 80, 78, 76, 72. This is how, in fact, we have also taken some water from sample from railway station. This is the work that we have done using some M.Tech student, but see, further it is needed to be, refinement is needed for taking the readings also. This is another application. So first application, it is for detecting, measuring humidity. Second application, measuring water quality. And third application that you have explored for measuring the water level. So water level, as I have told you, that constant phase behavior, it depends on pore size, it depends on contact length, it depends on the contact area and ionic concentration. So suppose if you want to pores and ionic concentration are fixed, then contact, according to the contact area, phase angle will change. So when you're going to dip your substrate more and more, in case of level detection, suppose water level is lower and gradually increasing. So contact length is, contact area is increasing, isn't it? So it means we can get the phase shift. So this is, in fact, the reading that I got, we got it. See, single coating, I mean, we have made different structure. One structure, contact thickness is, suppose, maybe 2 micrometer. Then we have made another structure with insulating thickness of 4 micrometer. Then 6 micrometer, I mean different way. See, things we have to optimize. This is the research that we are doing, isn't it? So by having a different thickness, we have to test our sample. So you see, I mean how sensitive it is. 1 centimeter, 2 centimeter, 3 centimeter. I mean in our real sense, water tank level you want to detect. 1 centimeter is very small, isn't it? Hardly this much is there. But it is giving good reading to us without dip. Jab dip nahi hai, toh minus 90 degree. Why? Because it is no ionic medium is there. So it should be minus 90 degree. Once there is a dip 1 centimeter, it is goes to 86 degree, minus 80 degree. Once it is 2 centimeter, it goes to 84. Once it is 3 centimeter, it further goes. Suppose if we fix the operating frequency here, 400. So there is a change of, you can say this is 86, 84, 82. Minus 2 degree shift it there. It means that 2 degree shift, we have to convert into a voltage signal. We have to calibrate in terms of the level of the liquid waters. This is, in fact, the response curve. Just I have shown the constant phase behavior in that. Response curve for different dipping length. For single coating system, you see, there is a, this is basically, ultimately I have told you that then the device is interface with a circuit. And then that circuit output AC voltage converted into DC, and the DC voltage we have plotted on this axis, and this is the dipole length. So this is the things that we want to detect. This is for double coating. So you see, 3 point almost one above, it goes to 2.3, okay? But this case, it is, what is happening? What is the difference we can see? Here, it is more sensitive than this one. But this is more linear than this one, okay? We need sensitivity, we need linearity. Now we decide how much sensitivity we want, how much linearity we want. You make a compromise, and you decide whether I should go for double coating or whether I should go for single coating system, single coating device. Then this is the work. This is done by, again, Professor K. Vishal, Siddharth Sen, and his group. This is in published in 2006. Okay, this is in fact constant phase element sensor for monitoring microbial growth. It means that is, it is basically the testing of the quality of milk. You know, this is so many times it is news that milk is adulterated, sometimes by urea, sometimes people add shampoo. They make basically even two liter of milk, they make 10 liter. It means out of 2 liter, 8 liter extra. So they earn lots of money. And you know, they, how they do that also I'll tell you. I mean, they add urea, they add some byproduct of cottage ghee to make the quantity of water. So what happened? In previous time, people add to water. Okay, then used to fight. Some, we have seen some elderly people, some children, they're going to milkman to stand, they wait to get directly so that they couldn't add water. It is a problem, isn't it? But now you add water, but don't add urea, isn't it? Things is changing now. So this is what is happening here. Again, same structure, double side copper cladded PCB, deposition of PMM acrylic film on both sides. PMA has a micropore. This is the structure. Same thing, this is the circuit they have used. I have also given one circuit, they have also given one circuit. What is that? This is one excitation voltage, this is one part CP, this is simply inverter, this two signal is given to a comparator, this is to voltage divider to reduce the voltage level, it is given to XOR gate to get the phase different, and ultimately phase is converted into DC. So this is basically, suppose signal A, this is phase shifted signal. If you see the difference, D is basically the width, which is proportional to the phase difference between the two signals. D is changing according to the concentration, or you can say microbial growth. So what will be the response? V naught is proportional to D. You will get this type of response. This is the behavior they have studied. CP behavior of PMM coated probe in milk and curd. Milk and curd. Let's see the difference. Data one, okay. Deep in 1 centimeter inside milk, and data two, deep 1 centimeter inside thick curd. Milk, pure milk, unadulterated, and curd. So dipping length is constant, as I have told you. Dipping length should be constant. So what is happening? This is a beautiful, such a significant change in phase angle over a significant frequency range. Milk spoilers. What happens if there is spoilage in milk? This is one important curve you can get from the literature. When there is a spoilage, different type of microorganisms are grown. And types of microorganisms vary according to the days. Ultimately, it is affecting the pH value. And pH value directly linked with the ionic concentration. Okay? It means ultimately it is affecting the ionic concentration, and that is needed for constant phase. So this is basically the behavior. It means for initially, for few days, Streptococcus lactis, it is having this, we are then lactobacilli, we have studied in biology, then film yeast, etc., then pseudomonas, spore forma, etc. This is the different organism that is grow. And this carb, thick black carb, it is the pH carb. So what happened? Initially, pH value start decreasing. Then after some time, it become almost constant. Then again, it start increasing. This is what is the nature of the microorganism growth and how it is affect the pH value. So it means if you are going to taste the meal with respect to time, so what happened? Milk, pure milk, even within a day, it gets spoiled. So it just take reading, first fresh reading, then after some time, then after some time, then after one day, and see what happens. So this is your first phase. Then it is second phase. Then it become constant. Then it is increasing. Then after it become constant. This is exactly, it is following this type of nature. Isn't it or not? This is decreasing constant, then this is decreasing constant, increasing. So initial phase one, steady state. In phase two, the pH of solution decreases steadily. Third phase, pH remains constant. Fourth phase, pH starts to increase, which indicates the decrease of conductivity of the reactive medium. Fifth phase, pH becomes constant. Sixth, response curve shows pH variation curve for microbial growth. So if there is a microbial growth, milk quality, then it is going to change. Milk adulteration. So three type of adulteration. Tap water, liquid whey, and urea. Liquid whey is basically the liquid byproduct of cottage cheese. They use this byproduct to make the milk. So addition of liquid whey, when addition does, add liquid whey, addition does not change the lactase content of the milk, but increases the acidity. It means it is basically the waste, you can say. When you make a cheese, it is liquid whey, it is a wasted thing. We just throw it. But people use it for making milk. Right? So what happens, in liquid whey, lactase content is not changed, but its acidity changes. Okay, it becomes more acidic. So what these businessmen they do, they add basic material to neutralize it so that people cannot identify. So they, what they do, acidity is neutralized by adding a small amount of NaOH, sodium hydroxide they add. Imagine it is the milk that we are drinking. They add sodium hydroxide to neutralize the acidic nature. NaOH, it is a base. We have used NaOH for polishing of silicon during my PhD work. Okay, it is a chemical we use for polishing silicon, and they use for making milk. Okay, so NaOH addition increase the life of milk, the consistency. Milk has a life, a normal pure milk, it can only stay for maybe few hours. 6 hours, you remember, in my house, my mother used to boil the milk instantly after coming from outside, isn't it? Other it get spoiled. So, hardly 5 to 10 hours it can remain, then it will be start spoiling. So it means what, when this NaOH addition, what is the beauty of this thing then? It increases the life concentration of milk. Added adulterated milk remain intact even for 2 or more days, while ordinary milk get spoiled in a day. It means if you add NaOH, your milk can remain safe for 3 days. But pure milk, within a day, it will be spoiled. It means the businessman, suppose they are not able to sell the product, milk. They can sell tomorrow, then day after tomorrow, it will not be damaged. But pure milk, within a day, it will be damaged. This is what is the beauty of NaOH. It is basic, but it is also increasing the life expectancy of the milk. Okay. They have made this same device for milk adulteration detection. They have made this type of arrangement using the constant phase device. And they have developed a circuit. So this is basically the circuit is there. It is given to the circuit. sensor, circuit, microcontroller board. Then ultimately, they're having a control valve to just check whether this can be used in a processing plant. They can use and test it for this type of application. Then they have used a result of water addition. You know, basically, they add sometimes water is added, sometimes liquid whey is added, sometimes urea is added. Okay, so different way you have to do the testing. So first they have done the test with water addition. This is original mill. PH was 6.87, conductivity 5.6, phase angle 6.91, tap water -8.09, mill 10% tap water -18.27, mill 20% tap water -19.29, mill 30% tap water 19.58, this way. But you see, still it is difficult. Much difference is not there. Though there is tap water addition of 20-40%, but you see hardly -2 degrees change is there. It needs to be more sensitive. Okay. This is with respect to urea. So phase angle at 18 kilohertz of the sensor, deep in original mill, urea adulterated mill, and corresponding pH and conductivity value. This is the conductivity. pH we see almost constant, is it or not? 6.6 to something there. Even conductivity also does not change much. But there is a change in original 15.68. But in case of 1.6 milligram urea, it becomes -9.52. So there is a change at least 5 or 6 degree phase angle change. So this can be used to make a system. Then liquid whey. Liquid whey, liquid byproduct, original this reading 5%, 30%. This is -13.63, this reading. And this is separate thing. Till now, that is a sensing application. Now it is the filter design. We know we use filter for removing the noise. It may be low frequency noise, it may be high frequency noise. We need low pass filter, band pass filter, high pass filter. So one typical example is there. Suppose this is a saline key low pass filter. We know different names is used for different type of filter. This is the circuit wire. Okay, this is the original expression. We know omega square, AC square, something we use the relation. Second order equation is there. Then second order filter become unstable when K is 3. See this value. If K is greater than 3, it becomes negative. If it is negative, then this the filter become unstable. It cannot become unstable. Can you control the stability by using a fraction order element in one of the capacitor? Any advantage by replacing capacitor with fractional capacitor? We are having a 2 capacitor, isn't it? So can you have any advantage if you replace 1 capacitor by a fractional capacitor? Just we have discussed. So if you replace 1 capacitor by a fractional capacitor, your transfer function becomes this one. To both the capacitor, S alpha plus beta, 1 minus K RCF S to the power alpha, this expression. Let us see the response. You see, response pure saline kick filter. It is unstable, going infinite. But this one become stable. It means the fraction order element, it can be used in circuit, in a filter, to stabilize the performance of the filter. So they have taken here alpha is 1, beta is 1, means pure capacitor. Alpha, beta, 1 length is pure capacitor. Then if here alpha 0.8, this is 0.4, this is value, it is going to, it means you are going to, we can improve the response of the filter by using a fractional order element. This is another filter they have used it. This is the response I am telling you. I have one more lecture today. I am trying to finish as early as possible. So this is the reference you can take for your own work. So slope in the cutoff region are also less than corresponding integer water filter. The performance of the fractional band pass filter is inferior to the integer. But here, this is one important thing, that it is improving the performance of a low pass filter, but not a band pass filter, can you improve the BP filter performance? Resonance, then another thing is that, can you have a fractional order inductor? Can you have resonance in fractional order circuit? How to define resonance? It means we can also design an RLC circuit for resonance. And we'll find that it can also improve the performance. This is the, in case of a RLC, series RLC circuit, isn't it? So we are having one resonance. When L and impedance of this and this nullify each other, it becomes pure resistive. You are having this type of phasor diagram. This is on circuit. It is fractional order inductor using generalized impedance converter. We use this circuit to make a inductor using op-amp, resistance, and capacitor. It is a very well-known circuit to convert resistance, because inductor, we always try to avoid in a circuit or in a PCB. Why? It occupies more space. It is a bulky also. But nowadays, some miniature devices are also available. So people, they have tried to replace, make inductor by using resistance, capacitors, and op-amp. So in this circuit, if you can replace some one element, Z4 by fractional order capacitor, then your L, this becomes ZL being LF S to the alpha, and it has been found. This one, alpha 1 plus, what does it mean? So it means current I in phase with applied voltage V. So OA is equal to, what is OA? This is VFL, this is OA is equal to OB, when power factor is unity, FL, FC both contributing to the overall resistance of the circuit, quality factor should be poor. Another possible way is OA not equal to OB, unity, overall admittance is maximum. This is by using the fractional order. So we can make a negative resistance using fractional order element. Make negative resistance means this negative resistance, sometimes it is used to compensating the some temperature error in certain type of transducer. So this can also be another possibility. So, but what is the challenges? Realization of a commercial fractional order capacitor, realization of a fractional capacitor for VLSI circuit, realization of fractional inductor without GIC, further application of fractional order device in circuit and system. These are the still challenges there, minus they are all research level, and we have to make in a practical commercialized way. So some effort they have made to make a commercialized fractional order capacitor, but they still having the problem of drift due to aging of a PMMA-based system. So here I'm stopping. This is further is there, stopping on here. I have to start my another lecture. That is on smart adoption, smart sensor. So after just few minutes, I will start, okay? Thank you.